Hi, I'm Erica, and I'm here at the Smithsonian's National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute in Washington, D.C. Today, we're going to meet Matt, a landscape architect. As part of his unZOOsual career, Matt designs outdoor spaces at the zoo. Now, before we meet him, there are three things I can share about Matt and his career. First, he uses STEAM, or science, technology, engineering, art, and math in his career. Second, he works with staff all around the zoo to understand the needs of people and animals for his designs. And third, he has to be really creative to imagine what a space could be or look like. Let's go meet Matt to get the inside scoop on his career.
Hi, I'm Matt Sellers. I am a landscape architect, and I help design the outdoor spaces here at the National Zoo. Landscape architects work on a variety of projects. You could be designing flower gardens or vegetable gardens for a home. You could work on a playground or sports fields for your local park. You could also design things like green roofs or rain gardens that not only look great, but also help the environment. When we begin a design, we often think about how the space will be used, not only by the people, but also the wildlife. And here at the zoo, we think a lot about how our animals will use those spaces as well. And in the end, we want to make sure that whatever we design plays well with the natural environment. So we're at the garden at the new birdhouse here at the National Zoo. I think this is a great example of what landscape architects do. We're standing here at the entry point from pandas as you cross the bridge over to Bird Plateau. And when we were designing this space, things that we thought about was, one, we needed to make sure we had a clear path for guests to go from the entry all the way down and around to the entry to the building, so people have a clear understanding of where they need to go. We also wanted to make sure that we had plenty of seating and benches throughout the site so that, you know, on hot days here at the zoo, guests really need a place to sit and rest a little bit. We also wanted to include a lawn area that would allow families and kids to kind of blow off some steam before they enter the building. We wanted to ensure that we had a diversity of trees, shrubs, and flowering plants that provided habitat throughout the year, as well as an important food source for our wildlife. A few examples that we have here. The tree behind me is called a serviceberry, so it has a nice berry that birds really love to eat. Additional berries can be found on some of the holly shrubs, as well as actual blueberry plants that we have in our garden. So they're not only providing food, but they look great as well. One really important aspect of this garden is that it actually helps the environment. So what you're seeing looks like just a typical planting bed, but you'll see that it's actually caved in just a little bit, so it looks almost like a big tub. So we collect all of the water from the roof of the birdhouse, and we allow it to flow into the planting bed. This is great for the plants because they love all of that water, but it's also great for Rock Creek, which is down at the bottom of the hill, because all of that water is now infiltrating into the soils and soaking into the soils here on site and not going into a pipe all the way down to the creek, which can have an impact on the fish and other wildlife that rely on the creek.
What tools do you use in your career?
One of the biggest tools that landscape architects use when they're designing are computers. So we use computers to help us draw our designs so that we can communicate them to our clients. We want to make sure that they understand what our designs hold and what they can expect in the future. We also, and this is super important, is use books and the internet for research. There's a lot of researching involved in landscape architecture. We're looking into plants. We want to make sure that we select the correct plants for the correct location, because many plants that we can grow here in Washington, D.C. wouldn't grow so well in, say, Texas, where it's a lot hotter, or up in Maine, where it's a lot colder. We also spend a lot of time thinking about hardscape, we call hardscape. So that's things like paths, terraces, benches, lighting, any kind of physical element that's outside that isn't a plant, we also have to think about. So there's a bunch of research to stay on top of to know that we are selecting the right material and the right plant for the right project.
What's unique about being a landscape architect at a zoo?
Two of the most unique aspects of working at the zoo are also two of my favorites. First is working with the animals and the teams that help take care of them. I learn all about their natural behaviors and their needs that help us create some of the most successful habitats that we can. The park also sees nearly 2 million people visit, and they come from all over the world. Seeing them enjoy the park and some of the spaces that I've helped create is very gratifying.
What skills are important for being a landscape architect?
Two skills I think are very important for landscape architects are, first, creativity. We face new challenges with every project, and some of them are very unique here at the zoo. Of course, designing for an elephant is a lot different than designing for a sea lion, and we have to find creative solutions that help us fit all of the needs of the project within the site given. Another skill is curiosity. We spend a lot of time learning new skills and new technologies that help us create our designs.
Thank you so much for joining as we explored another unZOOsual career. I loved learning how Matt designs a space with the natural and local habitats in mind. You can practice being a landscape architect just like Matt. Take a look at some of the outdoor spaces around where you live. Look at the greenery and how it's planted. And look at the hardscapes like sidewalks and some of the benches. What do you like about those designs? What would you do differently? Draw your own design for that habitat and compare them. I hope you liked meeting Matt as much as I did. He has certainly built a really cool career. Until next time.